Hello everyone. So today we are going to see the difference between the thermal technique of laser or EVLA for treating varicose veins and the VenaSeal technique. VenaSeal is a non-thermal adhesive based sticking technique for treatment for varicose veins. So first let's talk about laser, how laser works. So laser, as you can see this light coming over here, now it is a way of heating veins and closing the veins. How it works is the inside of the veins is heated to a very high temperature with laser energy coming from this point over here. All this laser goes all the way inside from the ankle all the way up to the hip, and then we have to give small injections of anesthesia. It's called tumescence anesthesia, around every 2 to 3 centimeters, and this numbs the area as well as protects the other tissues from burning. Now when we turn on the laser, only the vein that is intended to be burnt gets burnt from the inside and the other tissues are saved. But in doing so, we have to give a lot of pricks. So you can imagine it is around about 100 pricks or so required from the ankle up to the hip for the skin to be numb enough for the patient to not feel the heat. And in addition to that, after doing the endovenous laser ablation, it is compulsory for the patients to wear stockings. Now the duration for wearing stockings would depend greatly on the size of the vein that is treated, the number of veins that were treated, and the patient's general body type. Typically it is seen that patients need to wear stockings for at least 3 to 6 months after the procedure, and the veins they close gradually over a period of time, taking up to weeks or months. So that is what was about laser. Now one more thing about laser is that when we are injecting such a lot of fluid in the body, that is all the way around from the ankle up to the hips, it can take up to 500 ml of fluid that is injected. Now this amount of fluid, we have to be cautious in patients who have heart disease, kidney disease or other comorbidities, as we can't increase the fluid load in the body. That puts some risk, that increases some cardiovascular risk, and that needs to be protected. The patient needs to be protected from such a risk where we cannot inject such a lot of fluid just to protect the tissues. So that was about the endovenous laser ablation. Now we can talk about how VenaSeal is different from the endovenous laser. The VenaSeal, as the name suggests, is a method to seal the veins. Now how this works is it has a system of catheters in front. As laser is guided from the ankle up to the hips, same way the VenaSeal delivery system is guided from the ankle up to the hip. Now at this point is where they both differ. After reaching the hip, where the same place where the laser starts from, a little bit before that, we'll start treating with VenaSeal. Now when the VenaSeal delivery system is reached over there, we don't need to inject local anesthesia because there is no heat involved. This is a non-thermal adhesive based technique. Now when there is no heat involved, there is no need for anesthesia. The patient does not need spinal or a general anesthesia or sedation, as it is done through just one prick. Every 3 centimeters, we deliver 0.1 cc of the VenaSeal medicine just like this, and we have to compress that area for about 30 seconds to 3 minutes depending on the length of the vein, and that compression is enough to seal the vein permanently. It doesn't require long-term stockings. If concurrent sclerotherapy or some other techniques are used in addition to doing VenaSeal, then the patient might require stockings, but in general VenaSeal doesn't require the patient to compulsorily use stockings for a very long period of time. Now another benefit that VenaSeal does is because we don't need to inject that much amount of fluid, there is no tumescence anesthesia, there is no pricks, this can be done in very apprehensive patients also, without the need for a full anesthesia or a spinal anesthesia. In addition to that, in patients, now typically varicose veins, the worst patients of varicose veins are the elderly who are aged more than 50 years of age, and typically they have some amount of hypertension, diabetes, kidney disease and other such diseases. Now what happens is, in such a patient, we are not able to inject a lot of fluids, as that will increase the pressure on their heart and the other systems. And VenaSeal, because it doesn't require any fluids, the whole treatment can be done using 5 ml of the VenaSeal sealing medicine, as compared to laser, where it requires 500 ml of fluid per leg to be injected. So that VenaSeal, that is a big advantage with doing VenaSeal, where patients who earlier could not be treated because of their risk to other to the amount of fluids that can be injected can now be treated safely. Also, in certain patients who are on blood thinners, where we could not earlier give a lot of pricks in a patient with on blood thinners, if we are doing by laser, we could not possibly give that much number of pricks because then the patient would develop bleeding along all these small puncture points, and that can cause hematomas or bleedings inside the muscles. But as VenaSeal, it doesn't require all these pricks, and the whole treatment is done through one or two pricks. There is no additional pricks in the muscles. The chance of hematomas are very less, and they are down to nil. And we have treated patients with INR3, that is blood which is three times thinner as a normal person, and their ulcers have healed with VenaSeal with just one prick, without the need for giving a lot of pricks to with the laser. Now, this is where VenaSeal has an advantage over laser, but there is some rare scenarios where we need to use laser compulsorily as compared to the VenaSeal. But these are something where patients who had superficial thrombosis, that is, there is some amount of clots inside the veins, which we first dissolve by giving blood thinning medicines. Now, if there is a residual clot in the vein, then the VenaSeal medicine doesn't work as well. And at that point of time, it is advisable to do laser compulsorily as compared to VenaSeal. So, having said that, it is not wrong to do laser in a patient who is otherwise healthy, just that we have a safer option to treat now with VenaSeal that increases the safety profile for the patient. And maybe if you are going to do a procedure which is much less, then it is advisable to do that. That is that. Thank you for watching, and hope you understood the differences between laser.